I never thought I'd ever say this on TV, but check out Hillary Clinton barking like a dog.
One of my favorite political ads of all time was a radio ad, rural Arkansas, where the announcer said, wouldn't it be great if somebody running for office said something, we could have an immediate reaction as to whether it was true or not? Well, we've trained this dog, and the dog, if it's not true, he's going to bark. I'm trying to figure out how we can do that with the Republicans, you know? We need to get that dog and follow them around, and every time they say these things, like, oh, you know, the Great Recession was caused by too much regulation. You know?
I got to hear that bark again.
You know?
That is so my new ringtone. Anyway, she did that during a campaign stop in Reno, where she attacked Republicans as untrustworthy. Pretty ironic, Hillary barking like a dog, given that she's being dogged by everyone except Bernie over rampant fibbery regarding her emails, her server, and mistreatment of classified information. If you applied that joke, training dogs to bark at lies, whenever Hillary spoke, imagine what that would be like.
Can we talk a little about Russia? You famously pressed the reset button. Mm-hmm. Are you embarrassed by that now, that gesture?
No, I thought it was a brilliant stroke.
Wow, what good boys. Let's try this again.
I did not email any classified material to anyone on my email. There is no classified material.
They're like little furry lie detectors. Keep going.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
I'm sorry, how did that get in there? Anyway.
I certainly do remember that trip to Bosnia. I remember landing under sniper fire. There was supposed to be some kind of a greeting ceremony at the airport, but instead we just ran with our heads down to get into the vehicles to get to our base.
Even he could see through that one. More.
Did you tell them it was out the film, and what's your response?
No. You know, I understand the continuing grief at the loss that parents experienced with the loss of these four brave Americans. And I did testify, as you know, for 11 hours, and I answered all of these questions. Now, I can't help it that people think there has to be something else there.
I would have done more than bark. Finally.
Well, I can't think of anything more of an outsider than electing the first woman president, but I'm not just running because I would be the first woman president. I would not ask anyone to vote for me based on my last name.
Is that Cujo?
So there you have it. Every time Hillary opens her mouth, her campaign goes to the dogs. It's enough to make the Baja men cry.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Oh, my God.
We just have a minute.
It's official. The most immature show in television. I love it. But that was a beauty. The last one, who let the dogs out? Yeah.
She was pandering to the Westminster Dog Show.
Can I just add, didn't she know this was going to happen when she, I mean, that was close. That wasn't off the top of her head. She said, I'm going to go out there and talk about this story about the radio show and bark. And the campaign said, that's a great idea, Hillary, go do it.
Well, she does do Southern accents.
Right.
Yeah, she
I almost
she
like
does
when
black
she
accent. She has all kind of accents. That was hilarious. Let me say, I think
yeah, dog pilot, dog
that
pilot one.
That was your best ever. You know, I mean, politics aside, she opened herself to mockery, and Greg Gutfeld came right.
Last, we never ever found out who let the dogs out. Isn't that weird?
That is so weird.
Who pushed the video? Same person.
Exactly. There you go. Hillary let the dogs out.
She totally did on herself.
There you go.
Our work is done here.